Delhi Metro resumed its full services on Saturday with the Airport Express line reopening after a hiatus of over 170 days due to the COVID-19 pandemic. All corridors of the metro network are now in operation and the timing of services will follow the pre-COVID-19 schedule of 6 a.m. to 11 p.m. Drug Controller General of India, Dr. V.G. Somani, has ordered Serum Institute of India to suspend any new recruitment in Phase 2 and 3 clinical trials for the Oxford-AstraZeneca coronavirus vaccine candidate till further notice. The direction comes close on the heels of SII's answer to a show-cause notice by the drug regulator asking why the clinical trials for the COVID-19 vaccine in question were not stopped even after patient safety concerns surfaced. In a bid to diversify the underlying investments of multi-cap funds across the large, mid and small cap companies, Securities and Exchange Board of India on Friday modified asset allocation framework for such mutual funds. The market regulator has asked multi-cap funds to have a minimum equity investment of 75% as against the current mandate of 65%. Moody's Investors Service has joined the league of global rating agencies that have forecast a double-digit contraction in India's gross domestic product growth for the current financial year 2020-21. Due to the coronavirus-led lockdown disrupting economic activities. Moody's yesterday lowered India's growth estimates for the current fiscal to -11.5% from -4% estimated earlier. Millions of coronavirus cases may have gone undetected in India earlier this year, a research paper estimates, saying that for every confirmed case in May, there were 82 to 130 infections that were not recorded. The paper published in the Indian Journal of Medical Research estimated that the country had nearly 6.5 million cases as early as May. The business of Shapoorji Pallonji family is in dire crisis and their group is in talks to raise Rs 11,000 crore by pledging nearly 2% of their stake in Tata Sons, the holding company of Tata Group Companies. SP Group has signed definitive documents with Brookfield to raise Rs 3,750 crore.